Say, Lord, I praise you. I worship you. You are holy, mighty, King of kings, Lord of lords, the great I am. We love you. It's because of you that we are who we are. And we give you praise. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Whoo! Whoo! I took it all in. There is nothing like the presence of the Lord. The reason we come to church is because even though God is omnipresent everywhere, there is something that happens when you are in the presence of all other believers that stirs up a corporate anointing, that God inhabits the praises of his people. He rejoices when we come in one accord. You feel stronger, you go higher, you receive deeper. Hallelujah. We come to church because we are the church. Hallelujah. We come to stir up each other. Woo! Why we're here today. You know, when, Father, thank you for your word. You know, when at the race yesterday, what really touched my heart was the finish sign. When I saw that finish line, I think I got a second breath, third breath. Something happened inside of me. I saw it right there, finish, and suddenly I was like, and and it was this incredible visual that, oh God. Whew! It was this incredible visual because it wasn't like, oh, it's done and I'm through. Man. It was that this specific race I had completed. That I have taken it to the end. Now, I don't know about you, but I didn't want to cross it, you know, like that. You know, when we get to heaven, when we get there, whoo! I don't want to get there, you know, like, whoo, Jesus. Whoo, Jesus. Whoo! Whoa, Jesus. Jesus, I barely made it. I'm out of breath. There was time I didn't even think I was gonna make it here. Jesus, I thought you was gonna close the pearly gates on me. I thought, surely, she's too slow. She's not getting it quick enough. Jesus, But what I saw, what I have in my spirit is, you know, the last words of Paul to Timothy. Oh. Because, you know, we've been talking about fighting. But let's get this straight. No one has fought for you like Jesus. He fought sin. He fought death. He fought the enemy. He fought every darkness. He fought it for you. And you are his prize. Because let me tell you, Jesus won. He took it all the way. He took it to the cross. And you know, when he was going to the cross, he wasn't like, you know, like, I've never... No. In the Garden of Gethsemane, between him and Father, he lined up his will with Father. And when it was time to cross that finish line for the joy that was set before him, he saw you, he saw me, my God. And what he won is us. And you know, Paul, he said in Philippians, he said, oh, there is one thing I've learned to, I'm not perfected yet. He said, I like that. He said, I didn't get all together. I've not already. Oh, I better read some scriptures. Woo! My God. The scripture in Hebrews chapter 12, verse 1, that I'm referring to in 2 and through Genesis, he says, therefore, we also, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which so easily ensnares us. Come on, you know how easily the thing ensnares you? Let's move on along. And let us run with endurance the race that is set before us. Looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and has sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. Woo! And then in Philippians chapter 3, you make a left, you put your signal on. I want to give you the words so you don't think it's what I say. But in Philippians chapter 3, in verse 12, Paul says, not that I have already attained, or I'm already perfected, but I press on that I may lay a hold of that for which Christ Jesus has also laid a hold of me. Whatever you fought to get for me, I'm going to go after that. I'm gonna go on the race that's set before me step by step. And I'm gonna seek after and I'm gonna press on to lay a hold of what you saw on the cross when you laid a hold of me. Oh my, oh Jesus, don't let me press on what I think you got for me. I wanna press on for what you have for me. Then he said, but one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forward to those things which are ahead, I press toward the goal for the prize of the upward call of God in Christ Jesus. And the picture that I saw in 2 Timothy is the last word to Paul, to Timothy. I like last words. I pray that these last words could be our last word today, so that we don't have to think of them being the last words that we could say every day of our lives. I pray, that this would be something that we walking in our heart. In 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 7, he says those three incredible things. He says, I have fought the good fight. He says, I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. Woo! Well, when he gives his last speech in Acts 20 to the disciples, the elders and all that, he says something a little bit like this. He says, oh, you see, I've been through this. And I've been through that. Even the Holy Spirit bears witness that what's expecting of me, what's ahead of me, is going to be affliction and bonds, and it's not all going to be peaches, cherries. Before that comes, I might go through some stuff. But Paul says, none of these things move me. He says, neither do I count my life dear to myself that I may finish the course. And when I think of this finishing that he's talking about, that he said, I have fought the good fight. In other words, he says, you know, I fought a good fight. You know, I didn't go down for a count. You know, I did my best. I gave God my whole. I didn't obey him halfway. I didn't serve him halfway. I did the best I could, even though I had not already attained. I've learned to press on. I've learned that, you know, that this fight is not like a fight when you fight the enemy. It's more like a competition. He says, I fought a good fight, and it means more like I've pursued the contest with my whole might, and it's not just a race. See, what I saw yesterday was just not this race. I saw my whole life flashing every time I think about the Lord and everything that he has done. What I can tell you is that there's just this thing that he puts in us, that if we would just give him our whole and just pay attention to the one thing that he has for you to do today. And do that with your whole heart, with everything that you got. Might not be what somebody else got, but it's what you got. It might not be how somebody else would do it, but it's how God has created you to do it. It might not be as fast and as high as somebody else, but hey, nobody can do what you do like you do. Nobody can be you. You have pressed through. He made an effort. He fought the good fight. Because you know what? He says, hey, you have a cloud of witnesses that's been through some challenges. He said, hey, it's not all going to be easy. You're going to have your focus. You are going to have to see in the spirit the finish line. The greatest three word in the whole Bible is when Jesus on the cross, he said, it is. He said, it's finished. Ha! Not the little one race that I went through, But he said, hey, if you look unto me, the author and the finisher of your faith, everything that you will go through, you will be able to finish, because I am with you, and you will know that you're coming after everything that I have finished for you. I didn't conquer everything on the cross for you to live defeated, but victorious. I didn't conquer sin for you to let sin so easily come after you. I didn't conquer fear for you to let fear come in that easily. I didn't conquer condemnation for you to just let it come that easily. No. Everything that I conquered for you, I didn't conquer it halfway. He said, Telehestai, it is finished. It is done. Hallelujah. He was able to go through everything he went through because for him, he saw the finish line. He saw everything that was set before him. When I saw that sign finish yesterday, whoo! But let me tell you, along the way, not just in that race, but many things in my life, there were some times I thought, there's no way I'm going to be able to go all the way. There's no way I'm going to be able to finish the course. I remember one night closing the doors of the church 15 years ago and saying, phew. Now remember this one thing, is that God, if you tell me to do this thing, then even if at times I'm taking a step on my knees, even if I have to rest a second, even if I have to take a breath and breathe in the breath of the Holy Spirit, even if I have to call on the friends and the prayer warriors and everyone around me. My God, you get to a point in your Christian walk that you know that you have gone through too much to quit now. Quitting is not an option. Quitting is not an option. It's not in your vocabulary. It's not something that you might do. You cannot quit. Because oftentimes, the finish line in everything that you pursue is right around the corner. Right around the corner. I see this little hill, and I'm thinking, phew, 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 how much longer, Jesus. And suddenly, lo and behold, one corner. I see it. I see what you wanted to do in my life. I see the plan that you kept me from messing up so many times. I see the times that even though I messed up, you picked me back up because you could see what I couldn't see, because you were with me and you knew that every fight that I have gone through, when I look back in my life to see the victories in Christ, help me press through. Fight the race that is set before me today. And then one race add up to another race. And next thing you know, you finish the course. Now God is funny. God, it's not like when you go to school, you know, and you have like a course that's got 7 lessons. Because, you know, you can count down. Lesson 1, lesson 2, 3, 4, you know, you're like, hey, just 2 more lessons, I'll finish the course. Oh, he doesn't tell you when your course is. He doesn't tell you. For me, those 3 things, I have fought a good fight. You know, I didn't. I don't know about you, but I don't want the enemy to so easily do a countdown on me. I always figured if the enemy could get me, he would have got me before when I used to serve him. Now I serve him. I serve him. All that I do is for his glory. All that I do, even if I go through sufferings, it will be for him to be glorified. Hallelujah. Paul is talking even that he's looking forward to the crown of righteousness that is laid before him. And of course, the crown, we all know, we lay it back at his feet. But what he's saying is, all that I've done to please you, my king. All that I've done, maybe I didn't do it all the way right. But oh, Jesus, when I pass this finish line and I see you, it's going to be like when I saw that sign. And now in my spirit, I'm starting to see him clearer, you know, like brighter, you know, like, and I'm starting to have more stamina than ever before. I hear the cloud of witnesses around us. I hear them. And even in the natural, God put some people of God around you that will say, come on now, just a little bit. Breathe in. One more. You know what it's sad is when we start something and we don't finish it. All my life, I've often started this and, you know, before I was in Christ, I remember there was a season I tried to knit. Oh, Lord Jesus. I went to the store. I got every color. Every color possible. And I got a little crochet. And I sat down. I started sweaters, blankets, scarves. It started adding up that I had to get a basket. I had so many things started. Then I got born again and hey, The people I did the scars for, they never got it. When I went to get my master and my doctorate in theology, in ministry, I said, oh Lord, in counting the cost, you know, the scripture tells us, you know, if you don't count the cost, then if you don't know, if you're going to finish it, you're going to start. And I said, oh, Lord Jesus, you remember the scars? The scarves? You remember the blankets? Right? I said, you remember? I have the tendency to start things and not finish them. And he said, no. What you don't start, but what you do, because I started by leading you to do it. If you yield to me for your strength, for my divine ability, then surely it won't be like you in the flesh, because my daughter, I'm transforming you. You're not who you used to be. You don't have the things available that you used to. You used to count on your ability to finish. But now, if you keep your eyes upon me and you do what I tell you to do, then lo and behold, he who begun a good work in you will perfect it until the day of Jesus Christ. He said, I'm going to take you step by step. So every time I finished things in my life, I understood that I didn't do anything great and mighty. No, I just believed that he was great and mighty. And I just reached out to him. I lay a hold of what he laid a hold of me for. Even if at times there's things that I started and I said, Lord, it's not done yet. And he said, well, you're going to try to finish by it by yourself? No? So will you continue to wait for my time? Because when it's my time, if you yield to me, then I will anoint you to do what I call you to do. But you know, the hardest in all of that was to start by obeying his instruction. But then the beginning is always the hardest. We are talking on how the first mile is the toughest one. Actually, I would even say the first half a mile. Well, actually, the first quarter of a mile, in any ways, there's some spots that are the hardest. And if you know to press through those, then suddenly something comes upon you that it becomes like so easy, like you pass through, you know, the thing. You pass through it. It makes me sad when I see young people maybe shy of 2-3 credits to graduate from high school. And they don't find a way to finish. Makes me sad because, come on, all the tests you went through, all the little races along the way that you went through, all the way to get you to graduate from high school and you're just a few credits short, come on. Come on. Stay up 2 more hours. Same thing for college. Same thing when you set your heart. Do you think people easily? No, the scripture today says, no, the sin easily beset you. You don't have to fight against the sin. It always waits for you, tempt you. Not to do this, not to do that, not to do that. No, no, he said what you have to press on, press through, is at that very moment when you're about to quit. See, God wants all of us to know we're already champions in him because he said it is finished. So we already won. To win, that means in Christ that you are the first one, that you're above anybody else. No, no, no. To win, to be a champion, is when you finish the course. When Paul says, he says this beautiful thing. He says, I have kept the faith. The faith. The thing that tells you, in Christ, by him, I can do this. In you I live, I move, and I have my being. Even though I tripped, I'm going to get up and walk stronger than ever before. Even though I'm a few little credit shy, I'm going to go back to it. Even though I had to leave my dream when I was young, I'm going to press on through it. Whatever you called for me to do, I'm going to look at the road that you have set before me, and I'm going to take it step by step by holding your hand, by believing in you. I'm going to be a good steward of the faith that you're giving me, my God. I'm going to be pleasing to you. You know, God looks at the heart. He looks at the effort of your heart. He doesn't look at, you know, the natural accomplishment like men do. There's a whole lot of people, it could appear in the natural that they accomplished much. But did they accomplish something that they called themselves to do? What God looks at is not the natural. He says, none of those things move me. He says, I'm called to go over there and suffer. Here he says, hey, my day is becoming short. And he tells Timothy, no, I have fought a good fight. He says, I have finished the course. He says, I have kept the faith. Everything that I come against me, every temptation, every failure, every condemnation that came to cause me to look, even the faith that I had in the faith that you're giving me, I did not lose it. I kept it against all odds, against everything that came against me. My God, you kept me. You kept me. I've kept the faith. Woo! The Lord, He looks at your heart. He looks at the effort. He looks at the heart of obedience. For things very small to things very big, it's not the size of what you do. It's how you do it with your whole heart. How you never quit. How, like the song said today, you never give up because God will never give up on you. See, He already warned you. We belong to Him. When I try to pursue some things now, the only thing I always have to come against is impatience. Because I know God can create everything like, you know, 6 days, schlack, hip, let it be, let it be, let it be, let it be. Let it be light, schlack. Let it be the sea. Let it be 5 sweaters, 10 scarves, 20 books. Let it be God. You can do all things like this. What's the hold up? Excusez-moi, God. What are you waiting for? What's taking you so long? You need a little bit of help? Should I help you out? You know, impatience comes because you have faith. You make an effort not to get faith, but because you have faith. You believe in greater, so you make an effort to get the greater in God. It's because you have faith that you become impatient sometimes, because you know God could really do this thing quicker. So when God says, you know, go get your master of ministry, I'm thinking, hey, you're looking at what? 5 days. 3 days. What are we talking about here? Should I pay a grand and just get one on the internet? Right? It's like God, you know, no. God says the only thing that you're going to have when you finish your course, when you get to glory, even though we live in glory now, says the only thing is what's by my spirit. If we work of flesh, gonna be burned up. Whoa. All of them. So then I'm thinking, well, praise God, I didn't finish the scars. Because they wouldn't have made it to heaven. Because I'm not sure you let me. I'm giving that as an example. When I remember learning how to type to get a better job than working in the restaurant. And oh, you know, when I went for the job in front of the attorneys, when I think back now, I'm surprised they didn't laugh. Because I tell you the truth, I had so much confidence because I felt that, hey, I did a good fight. I stayed up late. I learned, I knew where to put my fingers, you know, so it, you know, like, I did my best. I did my best. And at the test, maybe. In front of the lawyers, right? But I'm really, you know. Like in my head, I'm a professional typist. Because I started the course and it was tough. It was the toughest thing for me to learn where to put my fingers without looking. To me, typing was that. Type without. So get S A. So to me, I had finished. When I sat there believing that I could do it in front of the attorneys, I was seeing the finish line. I've learned how to tie. And I think to this day they gave me the job because I had so much assurance that if God wanted me to get this job and he taught me how to tie, then hey, this job was mine. And I finished. But it was tough. I had the two girls. I was working double shifts in restaurant. I was, you know, to find the time. To sit, you know, back in those days, you know, that's why now I think it's so sad with the media that now, you know, I have to, I see people with just two, you know, don't. And I'm thinking, no, took me too long. You don't know what I went through to learn to type the whole word with both my fingers. And now you want me to learn to type with two fingers? No! No! I will buy your keyboard and connect it to my phone. But I'm a type, I know how to type whole words. I love English. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I finished the course. I took it all the way through. But it wasn't easy. In those days, they had this old. You know the typewriter, that ding? You know, you press return and it goes. And now you slide. Now everything you touch. It's just an incredible thing. So I'm giving you an example that I had to sit down late at night. Because to me, to get a better job that God brought my way, see, you do all you can do to the glory of God, and then God will give you favor right where you are. See, sometimes favor is taught without obeying God. When I'm talking about abiding in Him, doing your best, all to the glory of God, and then God knows where you are. God brings an opportunity of favor right where you are. And when that opportunity comes, you have to step in it, take the walk, run. If God tells you to do it, you can do all things through Christ, which strengthens you. Hallelujah. Lift your hands and say that. Say, I can. Do all things through Christ who strengthens me. I'm a champion. I'm a winner. I'm going to finish my course. I'm fighting a good fight. I'm finishing the course. I'm keeping my faith. Jesus, I surrender all. Whatever course, whatever race you set before me, even the one I'm in today, I will do it in you, through you, with my whole heart. I will give it all that I am. Hallelujah! Thank you, Jesus. Glory! Hallelujah! Hallelujah! It could be something as simple as taking care of a loved ones, being a mom that's raising a child. You know, one day somebody told me, I've done all I could for this kid. I said, well, what do you mean? Well, yeah, he's 16. I said, excuse me? You're never going to stop fighting for your kid. You're never going to stop putting everything that you have in you for your kid. You started raising your kid. You're going to finish the race. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The Lord today, He's asking us, are you living for me? Are you living by me? Are you living through me? The Lord today is asking all of us, are you letting some things move you? Is there some things you have put on the side that I've called you to do? There's some things that maybe you look to yourself, but you forgot that I was here to help you. There's some things you try to do, but warfare in your life stop you from doing it. Did the cares of the world, did the weights, did everything just like come and bury your treasure? Now I want us to close our eyes, and this is a moment just between you and Him to answer that question. And whatever you hear Him tell you to do, to pick back up, or whatever the race that is set before you, in your heart, if you feel like there's been any disobedience, just repent, tell Him, Lord, please forgive me, help me, get me back on the ways. If it's something that maybe you've been impatient, Lord, patience is a fruit of your spirit in me. Help, help me, help me. With you I can do this. With you I can finish this race. I will not look back in my yesterday. I will reach forth what's in my tomorrow. Yesterday is yesterday. Thank you, Lord, for your blood. Thank you, Lord, for your forgiveness. Your ability. It is finished. Thank you, Lord, for a second breath today. Holy Spirit is moving on every heart here today, and I believe that the Holy Spirit, when you come for prayer, and even now before you leave, I release upon you a second breath. Release a second breath upon you. An ability to stand, to press through a second wind, a second wind, a second wind upon you. And I hear the Lord say, even I've seen your heart in many situations, in things that you had your heart to do, and I've seen what has come against you. The Lord says, I am pleased with your faith. You have kept the faith. I am pleased with the effort that you have made. And now I'm going to anoint you with even more. And the Lord says there's some things that you have finished that you don't even know you finished, because I finished them for you. You have planted, you have watered, but I gave the increase to much fruit of your obedience, says the Lord. There's some things you finished in my name, you don't even know it's done. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, for your Holy Spirit moving mightily in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Go ahead and play this song, and I invite everyone to come for prayer. The Holy Spirit is moving. If you don't have to go to the buffet too quick, too soon, let the Holy Spirit move upon your life, because there's an incredible thing happening here today. Hallelujah. Continue to worship and let the Lord minister to your heart. My God, my God, how many races have you come through? So please come. If you new, come first. The new people come first, and the children.